Alleluia, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, who in the Paschal mystery established the new covenant of reconciliation, grant that all who have been reborn into the fellowship of Christ's body may show forth in their lives what they profess by their faith. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Now, the whole group of those who believed were of one heart and soul, and no one claimed private ownership of any possessions. But everything they owned was held in common. Great power, the apostles gave their testimony to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. There was not a needy person among them, for as many as owned lands or houses sold them and brought the proceeds for what was sold. They laid it at the apostles' feet, and it was distributed to each as any had need. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Read together Psalm 133. Oh, how good and pleasant it is when brethren live together in unity. It is like fine oil upon the head that runs down upon the beard of Aaron, and runs down upon the collar of his robe. It is like the dew of Hermon that falls upon the hills of Zion. For there the Lord has ordained blessings, life forevermore. A reading from the first letter of John. We declare to you what was from the beginning, what we have heard, what we have seen with our eyes, what we have looked at and touched with our hands concerning the word of life. This life was revealed, and we have seen it and testified to it and declare to you the eternal life that was with the Father and was revealed to us. We declare to you what we have seen and heard, so that you also may have fellowship with us. And truly our fellowship is with the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. We are writing these things so that our joy may be complete. This is the message we have heard from him and proclaim to you, that God is light, and in him there is no darkness at all. If we say that we have fellowship with him while we are walking in darkness, we lie and do what is true. But if we walk in the light, as he himself is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of his Son Jesus cleanses us from all sin. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he who is faithful and just will forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. If we say we have not sinned, we make him a liar, and his word is not in us. My little children, I am writing these things to you so that you may not sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the atoning sacrifice for our sins. Not for ours only, but for also for the sins of the whole world. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John. Glory to you, Lord Christ. When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, be with you. After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." But Thomas, who was called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hand, and put my finger in the mark of the nails, and my hand in his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were shut, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hand. Reach out your hand and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe." Now Jesus did many other things in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book, but these are written so that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that through believing, you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord. We come to the second Sunday of the Easter season. The truth of Easter is just maybe beginning to seep into our souls. It is hard on the first Sunday of Easter to do it about faith from the drama of Good Friday to the extraordinary act. Living with the resurrected Christ, a week of growing into that reality. That's why the Easter lasts for 50 days. Mary Magdalene goes out again and has this encounter with Jesus, and he calls her Mary. And after that comes today's gospel reading that we just heard, and it's the night of the very same day, and the disciples are gathered in a room, and the door is locked because they're afraid of the authorities, and Jesus shows up in their midst. And the first thing he says to them is, "Peace be with you." And then they see his wounds. And he says, "Look, look at my wounds, it's me." And they are filled with joy. But their joy is immediately countered by Jesus with the words, "As the Father sent me, so I send you." And so, although the point of Easter is joy, it never comes without immediately commissioning us to be the bearers of that good news in all the world. This is John's story about the commissioning of the disciples. Out of the joy of the resurrection, they are commissioned to carry his word, and then he breathes on them and gives them enough spirit, gives them his spirit, to carry out that task in the world. The second part of this story is about Thomas. And Thomas was not there. They tell him that they saw him. Thomas says, "I just don't believe it." And then the following week, they're again all together. Thomas is there. Jesus shows up and says, "He's risen." And he shows Thomas is the wound that he has. And Thomas says, "My Lord and my God." And then we're told that many other things, today's gospel reading, many other things happened in Jesus' life, but I don't have room to write them all here in the gospel. These I've just told you so that you may believe. And very often people think that this is in fact the end of the original gospel of John because of that kind of thing. There are two things that are useful to us, at least, in this story. One is the idea that joy turns into commission. That it's out of joy that we receive God's Spirit to do God's work. The point of Easter is not simply joy. The point of Easter is joy and being sent and empowered with that Holy Spirit. The other thing to notice in this story is the role that wounds play in it. That it is the wound of Christ that identifies him first to the disciples and then to Thomas. It is the wounds that are the sign that it is he. What might that mean for us? Well, it might be that for us to see the resurrected Christ, we have to see the wound first. Which means that we can look at the wounds in our own lives. And we can see them and see that out of them new life has come. We have not died from our sins. We have not died from all the tragedies of our lives. We have in fact become someone new. We have been given new life out of them. It is by looking at the tragedies of our life, by the broken places of our life, that we can see how God is alive through them. It is not that Jesus was a superhero and conquered death. It is that he undermines death by showing that life and love prevail. It is the victory. Easter is the victory of life and love, more centrally than it is the defeat of death. But that's the way Jesus does it. He turns the world upside down by demonstrating not that death can be defeated, but that life and love always prevail out of it. That's true in your life. It's true in my life. It's true in the life of the world. That out of all of the world's brokenness, life and love always give birth to life again. And that's the joy of this second Sunday of Easter, and that's why we're commissioned to spread this good news. And that's why this is good news not just for us in our little lives, but good news for all the world. If this story is not true, then death and darkness will prevail. We'll go spiraling down a dark path if it is not true that life and love prevail. And that's why you and I are commissioned to share this good news. good happening in people's lives and in the life of the world. And that is the task that's given to us on the second Sunday of Easter, as we continue to look for and encounter the risen Christ in this world.
Amen.
Proclaim our faith in the words of our statement of faith.
We believe in
God the Creator, by whom every person in heaven and earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in God, Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer. Amen. Risen Christ, we give you thanks for bringing us here to your table this morning. We pray that you will be with all people throughout the world in their various needs as we pray. Come, Risen Christ. Be with the people of Myanmar and in all war-torn countries, and with all those who live in fear.
Come, Risen Christ.
Be with all who work for peace, all who seek to alleviate suffering, and all who advocate for the least privileged in our world.
Come, Risen Christ.
Be with all those who need your healing power. Anthony and Doris, Evelyn, Barbara, Daisy, Hope, Joe, Greg, Terry, Melissa, Priscilla, Leona, Maureen, Lester, Susan, Adriana, Daniel, Adam, Emma, Marilyn, June, Francis, Kyle, Amanda, Linda, Nicole, and all refugees, for those suffering from the ravages of war and natural disasters, and those we now name as silently in our hearts or aloud.
Keep them in your
loving. Abuse and neglect, be with all the children of the world. Be with all of us, that we may know your home in our hearts, and with this parish, that we may be a sign of your love in this place. Remembering Fernando Albizu, Daniel D'Agostino, and all those who have died, we name silently in our hearts or aloud. That they may share in the joy of your heavenly kingdom. Come,
Risen Christ.
Great and living God, may we have eyes to see your risen Son in all of our lives. Teach us to love as he loves, to sing as he sings, to dance the resurrection to the end of the earth. Amen. And the peace of Christ be always with you.
Walk in love as
Christ loved us and gave himself for us in offering Christ to God. be with you.
Also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks.
It is right and the good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, God Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. But chiefly are we bound to praise you for the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. For he is the true Paschal Lamb who was sacrificed for us and has taken away the sin of the world. By his death he has destroyed death, and by his rising to life again, he has won for us everlasting life. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation. The calling of Israel to be your people, and your word spoken through the prophets, above all in the Word made flesh, Jesus your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before him. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin to righteousness, out of death into life. On the night he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Christ, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming of glory. And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where with all your saints we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Jesus Christ, our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. Now as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Alleluia.
Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us pray.
These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ rose from the dead for you. See them in your heart, God. Body of Christ. Let us pray. Eternal God, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And you have fed us with spiritual food and the sacraments of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, strength and courage to love and serve you in gladness and singleness of heart. Through Christ our Lord. Almighty God, who has redeemed us and made us his children through the resurrection of his Son, our Lord, bestow upon you the riches of his blessing. May God, who through the water of baptism has raised us from sin into newness of life, make you holy and worthy to be united with Christ forever. May God, who brought us out of bondage to sin into true and lasting freedom in the Redeemer, bring you to your eternal inheritance. And the blessing of God Almighty.